Hello, Gamers Nothing Report.
Welcome back to another episode of FTB Infinity Evolved. So I was just looking at some stuff. Some interesting things. We can finally make the alchemy catalyst. I did some things off camera just because it was a little bit of like trial and error. It really took longer than it should have, and I didn't want to annoy you guys with it. So how does this work? Do I just put it next to the mana pool? I don't actually know. Okay, and then I wanted prismarine, and the way you get that is nether quartz with this beside it. So I don't actually know how this works, but let's go try it. I don't know if you just place it beside it or not. Oh, to show you guys how I got it. So you know how I needed to make the golden chalk and I needed more power? So basically, I looked up a different guide on everything you should put on it. So I upgraded all the stuff around it. So these flowers, they're limited to about one or two each, depending. So I kept checking if the power was going up. A dragon egg is good, so I went and got our dragon egg from the end. Pumpkins, melons are good. I found cactus was good. Sugarcane was good, so I stacked it up super high. I put farms are good, so potatoes and carrots are really good, so I had that. Grass is good, and the actual trees. So all of these have limitations. Like grass, you can only have, I believe, 100 blocks of grass. The wood, you can only have 50 or 100 pieces of wood. The leaves are the same thing. Cactus, there's a cap of like 50. Same thing with sugarcane. And I made the Arthana thing. I can't put it in this spot, but I could put it in that one. If you have a wither and a skelly skull, it actually lowers the power, because the skelly skull is a 1x, the wither is a 2x, so you want the wither skull. The filled chalice, I finally got the redstone soup, which I did not know that you make it in the kettle and then you have to bottle it out, which is pretty weird to me. But we have the chalice now, and I put it on, and you can't have the empty chalice, so I have basically a wasted chalice, and I made the candelabra. For the extra charge up. So this is it right now, 97.50. So that was enough to make the redstone soup, and I made the golden chalk finally with this little ring for no reason. It used 5,000 for the thing, I believe. So that was fine, and now we have the golden chalks. We got the alchemy thing, so I'll go get the nether quartz now to go make it. Also, I keep hearing people that I watch play this pack. They are way behind where I am, but that's besides the point. They're not as tryhard as me, so it was interesting that they updated to the 2.2.2 update, and now they're crying nonstop about the nerfs to diesel generator. Like, whatever. I don't know. It's interesting. I'm not going to bring up names to start drama, but like, you updated knowing that that was a thing you probably shouldn't have, if you're going to complain. Like, I'm not going to update because I think it's stupid. To nerf a diesel generator to a quarter of its power mid-game, mid-playthrough, that's almost like saying, hey, I just don't want to use this as power anymore. So how do I use this? It still says, 1 second. I just don't know how to use this, so when placed underneath. See, like, how would I have known that? Hey! Hey, baby! Hey, baby! Okay, so now I can. So how many do I need? So we need the blocks, and one of those is my blood orb. Okay, so we're already good, right? I can go make it right now. Eight. This should be good to go. Let's go try it out. So we'll finally be using my... Oh, I don't have my dagger on me. For some reason, FPS drops. Like, I'm sure if I check, yeah, 10 FPS. What the fuck? Dagger. There's also a weird noise down there of a machine on that makes some fucked up noises. Okay. Lag. Okay, let's play... Nope. Let's place it in. You can. I turned on particles, so you can finally see it transmuting blood to it. Let's turn on the spawner. Pretty good. So I have to do 5,000 to get my second blood orb. It would probably be a good idea to get a ring of speed runes around this, so I can transmute the blood faster into my things and make more items very faster. Which I'll end up probably keeping speed runes on this anyways in the late game, so it'd be a good idea to upgrade. Come on, give me my blood orb. What does it take to make this? Can I use a shitty blood orb, or did I need the... So there's the apprentice. And yeah, that's why. Oh, there we go. Oops. Oh, that's my first monster kill, boys. You've never seen me kill monsters before. Okay, anyways. Let's make it mine. We're now connected. Let's go get... I guess let's make some of the next stuff. So speed runes... Sugar, reinforced slates, so we need to make more slates. We need more blood runes, we need 8 more. Okay, yeah, so slates. I need 8 of these. Do I have any more of the shit that turns into blood runes? Let me check. So I need to make more slates, and I need arcane stone. Okay, yeah, I got a bunch. Cool. Oh yeah, because I never actually transmuted them because I was upgrading my system. So can I actually make any speed rune right now? Let me try. Because if I have... Okay, so I need reinforced slates. And I'd need to make more blood runes, technically, to be able to, without ruining my tier 2. Okay, yeah. So I guess we should just go transmute all this into slates for sure. Like, that's a guarantee. Haha, guarantee. Alright, let's bring down the mobs. Three blank slates. I'll need to turn 8 of them into reinforced, and then I think we're good to go. I need to make more waystones as well. Other than that, I'm good to go, because I have the shards, I have the stone. So really, it's just the slates that are the bottleneck right now. So I'm just going to keep killing them until the blood runs out again. And then I'll let them build up again. Like right now, since there's still blood in there, there's no point in killing them. I think that's enough in there. I wonder how much LP I have in my network. See how long this takes, and that's why I want the speed runes. Just to make normal slates, it takes forever. I'm sure it'd be faster to make the the reinforced ones after. I take quite a lot of damage from that fall. It's irrelevant, but just saying. I really want the divination sigil too. Like that would be so nice to have to be able to check the LP. Oh yeah, that's what I also was looking at. It's a niter. I already have one, don't I? And I could make that right away. That's actually really cheap. What other sigils would be really nice to make? Nothing really. Is that super important? The other stuff is more utility. That's actually part of, like, the core. Alright, let's turn that off. So if it took that little bit of time to get the blood orb, I wonder how long it'll take to transmute 21 of these, because it's 4 times as long, it shouldn't take that long, right? Look at all that blood. We'll delete the trash while I'm sitting here waiting. I made a mistake last time, which is why I just ended up fixing up the mob farm. I took out these by accident. I was pretty sad. Sad day. Can I go make this and then come back? Yeah, probably. That would be nice. I have the niter, and I have the blood orb, and I have the glass. Oh my god. Blood. Wow. I swear I just searched up mana glass. I didn't see it. Oh, there was. Oh my god. Okay, cool. Nice. 4,800. Not bad. That's irrelevant because I have nothing actually using LP from my network right now, but it's still cool. And then obviously I can come over here and I can go. Oh my god. Alters current essence. Why is it going down? If they're all transmuted. Oh, it's already making the tier 2. Yeah, no thanks. Let's take those out. So I need 8 of them. Then this should be a lot quicker. So we can peer into our table. So since they were updating the stack in there, it wasn't taking any LP and now it is. Finally. So they go really quick for tier 2. For these ones. Hey, look, it's showing it's empty. Come on. So this, I should actually be running out of LP, I believe, I think. Runes of Sacrifice wouldn't be terrible either. And how expensive are those? It basically makes these kills worth even more. Oh yeah, so those are easy. It's this is the problem. I need a tier 3 altar to get it. I can't make it yet. So, yeah. This is tier 1. Tier 2 is this row. Tier 3 is that one. So you can see it's a lot of blood runes I need to make it. How close is this? Yeah, so for making these slates, the tier 2 slates, it's not a big deal. It's when making the tier 1s. So I think logically, since in the end, it's like it takes 184 total runes to complete the biggest size blood altar. I can literally just make all the slates I can right now, and I won't run into a problem. It'd be a good idea so I can actually upgrade my altar. And I also need to make tier 3. It's just glowstone. It doesn't get hard till the bloodstone bricks. which I think are actually easier in this pack, if I remember correctly. Let me look that up. Yeah, look, it's Ritual Stone and found a different recipe. Okay, maybe I didn't. It still takes a weak blood shard, and the only way to get that is by killing a demon. Never mind. I think that's good enough. I'm sure it's going to transmute now without killing anything else. Oh, thanks, man. I don't want all your trash. So then I can get like a stack of the ruins and, or whatever, and make slates, which will be nice. I'll have to automate taking out the finished slates though, because I don't want them transmuting all the way to the latest, to the farthest thing. Or the reinforced, for example. I can't automate it because I don't have a way to automatically put LP in. And never mind, I can just speed it up. So there we go. We have 8 reinforced. I should take these. Oh, there's also something really soon I want to do to my tools. Or did I already do it? I already did it. I didn't even notice. I forgot I upgraded to Endurium already. I want to make an Endurium crossbow, though. Because soon I'll have to start farming Ender Dragons. I haven't done it yet, but I'm doing magic right now. So we have 8 blood runes. I need to make more. Blood rune. I need 8 more. So obviously I need the waystone, so I need flint. Let's go do that. And then... So I need 8 of these. Shouldn't be a big deal. Make like a stack. So that turns into gunpowder because of the catalyst underneath. So let's remove that and then... Hey! 16. 24. This will fill up as I'm waiting anyway. There we go. Put back the catalyst. So I guess I should just leave that open so I can take it out. That would make the most sense. I actually think I'm one off, aren't I? From getting this. Can I make... I already know I can't, actually. So I have 7... I have 15. Yeah, I'm one off. God damn it. Okay, so speed, ruin. I want to actually try this because I wasn't able to try it before. So can I use my weak one? See, I actually needed to get this apprentice one, which is why I needed to finish the Batania catalyst. I knew it. I didn't actually know for sure, but I knew it. So now we have 7 plus 1. And then I want more of the, arcane stone blocks, which if I can get a conjuration catalyst, that lets me make, double of things, like, for example, these. I can double it with mana, which is really cool. So we need living rock, shards, and stone. So let me get more living rock, shard, and stone. Glitch again. Okay, stone. Okay, let's go make some. I should really make more living rock. So we'll take the stone and we'll start making these. Realistically, I should get more pure daisies. I don't have enough. Since they have such a long cycle. Okay, that's good. Is my wand in here? Nope. It's in my inventory. So it's living rock. I forgot this made so many recipes. I was thinking 8 per for some reason. Okay, and shards. 40. Not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, so we can go make 40 slates, which is pretty good. How much are item conduits with an item filter? That would be very helpful. That's not terrible. I'll do it. Not terrible at all. It's worth it for getting to save, doing, waiting for it. So item conduit. It's definitely really expensive, but nothing does what this does from what I remember. And this isn't super expensive for me anymore. So I just need conduit binder. So I need binder composite, which isn't expensive either anymore. So I believe I can just do... Hopefully that worked. Yes, it did. Let's make item conduit. Okay, and then I need an item filter. Need a basic hopper, item filter. Let's get an empty slate. This should work. Oh, I need a chest. There we go. Extract with item filter, and we put this in. Okay, so it should only extract if it's that, and insert. Okay, now I can place back my runes. So cool with speedruns on here. Finally. We're getting somewhere in blood magic. So I'm basically just going to be doing the base blood magic to learn or to make, like, force myself to get the necessary stuff from the other mods without going super into them. We'll see how that works. Oops. It shouldn't be transmuting until all of it's in. That's odd. Okay, let's turn this on, because this will quickly run out now with the speedruns on here. I could actually add that capacitor upgrade probably and it would keep up. Maybe not. It is 40 a tick now, which is pretty fast. Yeah, it is running out. It's okay though. Should be fine. The only problem with doing that I did skeletons is the fucking drops. It's so annoying getting bows. Oh yeah, no, this is fun. Wow, we're getting a lot. I remember I put torches up there. I actually don't even need to have torches in there. We can just have it spawning naturally. I should really change that. Yeah, why do I even have torches in here? Doesn't make sense. Wouldn't I want more mobs? Logically, I'd want more. Okay. Now random mobs can spawn in there. Oh, they accept for spiders, and it'll clog it, and that's why I did that. I forgot. Do I care? Not really. Well, we'll see if it's a problem later, and I'll just put torches. Okay. Damn, my FPS fucking took a hit for a second. This is 40,000 LP I'm trying to farm right now. And you may wonder why. Well, I need to make the tier 3, and the tier 3 requires a lot of runes, so I actually could have used these runes that I made towards making the last, the next row, but realistically, having speed runes to make the next ones faster seems just better to me. There's no point to start making the tier 3 unless I can make the entire tier 3. Is 40 slates enough? That's 20 blood runes, right? And how many do I need? 28. No, 20. Okay, it's exactly 20. So if I finish this, I have enough for a tier 3. Perfect. It appears that nothing spawns up there anyways. Maybe I'm too close. Not bad, not bad. Yeah, something had some like thorns on it or something. Ouch. Oh man. Wonder how much has already been transmuted, if it's 40 LP a tick. I'm gonna let these build up. Yeah, I didn't need this item conduit actually, because I haven't automated it yet. Once I automate it, then it's useful. LP was getting low, and then... Hey, look, we're back up to 4K. Not bad, not bad. I wish it... Oh, hey. That was pretty quick. So we have 41. That's enough. I'm gonna just kill the last couple. Alright, we're good. Let's actually take that out, too. Delete the extra... We Gucci. So let's go make these blood runes to make the tier 3. We'll just make normal blood runes for now so we can make runes of sacrifice. Blood rune. Obviously, I just need my blood orb now. Craft all 20, take my blood orb. What is it for the next blood orb, actually?
Thaumium block.
And a tier 3. Yeah, I'm good. I'm good for that. Could totally do that. I guess I should, right? I don't know what I'll need it for, but sure. Blood runes, 20 of them. Then we want to look up rune of sacrifice, because this will make it even faster.
So we'd need imbued slates and more blood runes.
Okay. Interesting. Because then... Oh, I also need runes of, like, capacity and stuff. Because I'm going to have to do a ritual, which takes, starts to take, stuff out of the... What is it, my LP network? I think so. So I have to start having... LP a large amount to do the rituals, which I'm sure that the rituals will force me to do other magic mods for it again, because it's stupid. I just realized that, what the hell, isn't it supposed to be 20? So this is empty, this is supposed to be empty, and this is supposed to be empty. That's where my extra 3 are. Yeah. And then I normally use, like, let's see, how tall is it? 2? This is where I can put glowstone in, which I should have grabbed it while I was down there, because I already knew I was going to need it. Oh, let's go get it. Rituals are where I can finally automate it. So basically, I can just leave it on and like the spawner and stuff, and it'll automatically create LP, and I can put it straight into my network and stuff. Which, if I remember, the bigger blood orbs contain a higher LP network, like contain more and give you more back or something. I don't know. Anyways.
Let's get.
What did I need? Glowstone. So I actually have a. You guys may remember, I have an ender quarry in the Nether. I moved it to the Nether. So now I'm getting glowstone and nether quartz and all that. Surprisingly, I've only gotten 129 glowstone. How that's possible with 19k nether quartz is kind of crazy. So I think that's good to go. We don't need torches here anymore now. Okay, next. I'd want to look at, I guess, do I want to continue using Thaumcraft or would I rather use mana to create my stuff? Because if I make a conjuring catalyst, let's see if it's even possible. If I make this, I can start. Oh God. That's easy. How do I make Terra Steel? That's super easy too. It's just Terra Steel, that's the only thing. How do you make Terra Steel? Maybe we don't have any. Then I can start making automated stuff with rituals and or then I can also use mana instead of my vis from Thaumcraft. Okay. Oh yeah, and what's the superior capacity or something? Let me look up what the runes are. So I have superior capacity to increase capacity of my LP of the for the altar. I can increase the amount that can be stored in my soul network with the rune of the orb. Rune of dislocation. It helps speed the removal and transfer of the LP, which is only useful when you can have multiple altars, one for killing and the other one for increasing your LP network. You can just farm one and put it all into your blood orb, and the other one can be focused on just transferring it into the huge altar, and making stuff with it. Or you could also have three. You could have three altars eventually. It gets kind of crazy, but okay, so what are the ritual stones cost in this? Just curious. Ritual stones, cheap and cheap. Okay, so I need to obviously look at some of the stuff. So ritual chalk, that's fine. Oh, hey, I need each of the runes. So, oh, I just put items on each on this thing to make runes, eh? That's not hard. Okay. So I can make those. Cool. Okay, and now how do you make Terra Steel? Let me look that up. Terra Steel. It's probably something with the rune altar or whatever. Runic altar. To create a single Terra Steel ingot, the player must perform a ritual-like infusion. First inactive terrestrial or agglomeration plate will need to be constructed, structured. Then the player must throw a mana steel ingot, a mana pearl, and a mana diamond in order, in any order on top of the plate, utilizing at least a half full mana pool. Nearby clouds of mana should appear and circle the terrestrial agglomeration plate briefly and clash together until finally, upon a final clash of the mana clouds, a terrestrial ingot shall be created and dropped on the top of the plate. Oh. So I need a terrestrial agglomeration plate, which is this. So it's one of each rune and a block of mana steel and then lapis. So do I have all the runes? They're downstairs, I believe. Let's go grab those. I think I have a bunch of mana steel from the dungeon chest. So we're missing one of the runes. So I guess I'll go make the last one and I'll put these in. I'll keep them in my inventory, so just for looking. What's the last one? It was like purple. Let's just look up the terrestrial. It's Rune of Mana. So, 3 mana steel. Another balance shard. God damn it.
That's a lot of balance shards I have to keep using.
Okay, so mana steel, mana diamond, mana pearl, mana quartz. And then a balance shard, and I have to look up how I made it last time again. Because I used something else to do it. Okay, so 2 cobble. I'm gonna make 4 of the recipe. Sugarcane. Blaze powder. And so I need order shards. Okay. Cool. So that'll make me 2 balance shards, and that's what I need. I also need to make a mana diamond. So I'm pretty sure that I can't just throw the diamond into this current thing, because it probably it will work. Oops. Thank you. Then over here I need a bucket. So I think it's 3 buckets. Because this shit's obnoxious. Oh no, it's 1. Okay, we're good. So half, 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 half.
There we go.
So let's get ready. Gobble. Balance shard. So again, balance shard. Okay. So we're good to go, right? Now I just need to place these on the table. So right. Isn't that the way you make it?
I'm not missing anything.
And then it takes mana. So, we have that going to it. Is that enough? How do you... There's something I'm looking for. I think it's this. One of these wands. So any of them work, right? So I just need to go make a wand of the forest. I think that's what I need. Let me go get it. I don't remember exactly, but I'm sure it's how it works. Wand of the... So I'm probably missing literally everything. Let's craft this. Let's craft this. Boom. Oh, there we go. You see it said it, and it says unknown status, and this shows unknown status, and oh my god, all the animations are so cool. Oh, it's showing the timer. That's so sick. Oh my god, the animation, it's so cool. What the heck? This is crazy. Batania, please. Wow. It's done, isn't it? How long does this keep going? How long does this go for?
What the heck? How long do I wait? What the heck? Do I just like. Let me look it up. Because it's done. So I don't know. Do I just like shift click it? I don't know. The rune is an integral part of creating items. Rune is created with the two place and right click it, insert it above, they use the wand of the forest to activate the order to draw mana when blue lightning starts arcing a throw on a living rock. How would you know that? How would you fucking know that shit? So stupid. Oh. Nope. Oh, yeah, and right click it. Don't forget to right click it. Okay, so we got the rune of mana. That was all for a rune of mana. Oh my god. Okay, so now we can go craft our terrestrial thing, our majigger, and let's get this ready. Boom. Only thing we're missing is a block of mana steel. Boom. Boom. Okay, so let's go put this, first, an active terrestrial will need to be constructed. Then the player must throw a mana steel, blah, 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 in any order on top of the plate, utilizing at least half a mana pool, nearby clones of mana shell. So what, do I have another one of those mana spreaders aim at it? I'm going to assume yes. Don't actually know. Let's also grab the items. So I need a mana steel, a mana pearl, and a mana diamond. Mana steel. Mana diamond. Mana pearl. Got a bunch of pearls. So let's go get a diamond and we'll go infuse that. Then we'll mana spread the shit over. And we'll see what happens. These cobble don't make sense here. Okay, so we'll have this to this. I don't know if that works. Let's do. God damn it. Cool. So now, how do I make sure this works? I need to aim it down. How do I. Oh. Okay, no. Let's aim it. What? How do you? And then, does this? Oh god, I wasn't supposed to right click it yet. Let me look up a mana spreader and how to move these. The direction of the mana burst can be manipulated by shift or right clicking it on it with a wand of the force is an alternate method of orienting a mana sphere that is to bind it to another block. To do so, the player must simply shift right click the mana sphere, then shift right click another block to automatically orient to direct its mana burst to that block. Mana spreaders fire mana in a... Oh. There we go. Okay, that was good. So that's there. I guess I need to put these on. So I actually have to toss them on. Nope. God damn it. Let's go from above. This'll work, right? There we go. How do I know if it's working? Showing animations. So that's good, I guess. Was this right, or am I supposed to just put it next to the mana pool? Must throw a mana stealing get a mana pearl on a mana diamond any order on top of the plate. I don't think I'm supposed to do it like this. Yeah, I'm gonna move this. And I'm gonna remove this. Let's just place it here. Let me go get something. High amounts of mana, OP, OP, OP. I don't know if that's gonna work, but we can try. Is it going up? So I'm just registering all the endo flames so I can know what's happening. There we go. They all have a block or mana spreader to go to, so that's good. Why can't I get this to half? What is this doing when I right click it? What is this doing? It's consuming the charcoal, so that's a thing. I guess it's working. Is this just speeding it up by me right clicking it? Why is it not getting mana? How much freaking mana can a mana pool hold? So how is this supposed to make mana steal? It's not very clear. Let's look up a better guide, I guess. Better page for it. This item it was made one of each to make it, throw all ingredients and provide it with a half up mana pool's worth of mana via sparks. That's the equivalent of one full mana tablet. Wait, where the hell did it? Oh my god, it ate my. It ate my fucking stuff. It got deleted. They actually got deleted. Okay, let's go get a mana steal and their shit again. Mana seal. Mana pearl. Diamond. How does this work? Is that working? How does this work? I don't get it. It doesn't make sense. Is it working now?
Does me right-clicking actually speed this up?
I have no idea. Let's just... Here, one sec. One sec. You can probably hear that. Is this gonna work? Let's just keep going and see what happens. Maybe it's faster to click the freaking mana pool. Nope. Definitely not. Is this gonna work or not? It seems a little crazy that you have to send this much mana through mana spreaders. One second. Should I like watch a video on someone doing it? Like I really, this is a little crazy. What's a spark? Am I supposed to make that? It said VI Sparks. Which, I, obviously, the cheapest one would be the one I do. Let me go craft that really quick. Why is my FPS dying? 7 FPS, boys. My FPS... Yeah, there's no way you do it with mana spreaders. It just takes too long. My FPS, it's dying. Learning mods, boys, this is how you do it. You waste a ton of time. Okay, so I have no idea how you use a spark. Let's change my controls back. I was trying to use an auto clicker to see if it's even possible to do it with that. Clearly, I don't think so. I should have just, the first guy didn't say a spark, so that's why it's confusing as shit. And my FPS is Ebola. So let's lead this back to there, this back to there. Let's send it. Let's update the mana pool. Okay. I should break this one. Lead this one back to the runic table. Altar thing. Then I need more mana. Which would be the endoflames doing that. I need more charcoal if I want. Oh my god. Yeah, the Enderflames create decent mana, but not like a crazy amount. It's just faster to do this. Do I have a lot of wood? Yes, I do. Just want to make sure I have more at the ready. I have no idea what I'm doing with the spark, so let's just place it. Okay. Sure. I guess that's how you use a spark. Right click the terrestrial thing once I have the stuff on there. Okay, let's throw my charcoal in to the open crate. I need to go make another mana diamond and mana pearl. God damn, my FPS is so bad. What happened? I already have that. One of those and a diamond. You only really notice it when I move. 8 FPS. What the fuck happened? Thank you. So let's let the bottom one runs better. Take a look at that. So I'm converting the charcoal into mana, basically. Like, I could basically create a farm to just get me wood, and I could use that in here to make mana. How fast would these be without me touching them? I don't think it's very fast at all. Let's just turn that entire stack of charcoal. Almost out of the charcoal already, I think. It's a good learning process. And this is to make the catalyst, by the way. This is all to make the catalyst. I'm learning how to do Terra Steel from the ground up because I've never done it before. That's so much mana. I wonder if there's a better way for me to create mana, since I literally could do anything right now. And we're out of charcoal. Oh wait, there's still some more something. I don't know how it's getting more mana, but... I just want to create one Terra Steel before I end the video. Okay, that's it. And that one is all. God damn. What the fuck? I have taint over here. Didn't even notice. There we go. Fix that so I don't have fucking taint. Garbage in my house. I'm gonna end the video, guys. I'm just lagging so freaking bad. I'll start it up, I guess, when I'm not lagging. Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like if you guys did. Leave a comment in the comment section below about mana production and what I should do. And if I'm on the right track by making a spark. Thank you. Subscribe if you guys are new, and I'll see you guys in the next video.